Bob Barker saying good night, everybody.
Genre.
At the beginning
thing was hard because they were like, oh, this guy's only pretty, whatever it is. He looks good and whatever, but he doesn't sing. He has no talent.
Do people doubt that you write?
Oh, yeah, poems. Everything. They were like, okay, this guy, he doesn't have any talent. And that's where all my athlete mentality came right away. Started going to the studio every day and making music every day.
It's paid off. Lyrics pushing the limits of sex and luxury have made him enough money to buy more than a handful of pretty toys. A stable full of show horses, even a one-of-a-kind purple Ferrari.
I used to play like with Hot Wheels, and I always wanted to have them like in real life.
I went out to my 17.
Young and a rising royal, he has already shared court with the queen of pop at her behest. Madonna came to Medellin to sing a song named Medellin.
Oh, yeah.
With you.
I was seeing like people who I grew up, like a teacher from high school, my friends from high school, everybody was there. So when I saw her coming up on the stage, I was like, is this actually happening? I'm not going to do it because you just think you're going to be pop. So, hola!
Manifesting dreams is the purpose of his foundation, El Arte de los Sueños, in the heart of Medellin. Emboldening at-risk youth from across the region to tap into their own reggaeton warrior potential.
It's beautiful. It reminds me when I started just wanting to conquer the world.
Signing comes dexterous and silence. It's possible with James Hardy.
No matter how old we are, at the end of the day, most of us just want to be happy. But what does happy mean? Oprah Winfrey went looking for answers, and as Nora O'Donnell tells us, she turned to one of the pros.
How long have human beings been chasing happiness?
How long have human beings been walking the earth?
Arthur Brooks' life mission is sharing what he's learned about happiness with the world. In fact, it's what the Harvard professor is paid to do.
So your day job is teaching happiness at Harvard.
Yes.
How did that get on the syllabus?
The secret to happiness is actually teaching happiness. That's the reason I do it, is because it's not research, it's me-search.
To his great surprise, his lessons reached far beyond the classroom, to include one star student.
How did you find Arthur Brooks?
During the pandemic, I was in search of fuel to keep myself inspired, to keep myself open to possibility, to keep myself hopeful. I started reading his column in The Atlantic, and then looking more and more forward to that column on how to build life.
So that's when Oprah Winfrey decided to personally reach out to Arthur Brooks.
The first time you picked up the phone and you hear a voice on the other line say, this is Oprah, what did you think?
Well, I said, yeah, and I'm Batman.
But it was Oprah, and she invited him over for dinner.
And I'm thinking, what happened to my life? You know, I'm just a college professor fell off the turnip truck in front of Oprah Winfrey's tea house.
He is the perfect person to have for dinner because you just probe his brain about all the things you ever wanted to ask about your own emotions and searching for happiness and well-being and all of that. So I am the kind of person you know that believes that life is better when you share it, whether that's bread or information.
To share that information, they hatched a plan to co-author a book.
It's pretty nice when Oprah says, let's write a book together.
It's not the worst thing that can happen to you in your life as an author, that's for sure.
The book builds itself as a guide to getting happier, and the formula is not what you might think.
I'm going to tick off a few things that people may associate with happiness, so you tell me yes or no if they are necessary for a happy life. Money.
No.
Fame.
No, no, double no.
Power.
No.
Good looks?
Nope.
None of them. But if you were an alien and landed on Earth, and specifically in America, and looked at social media, you would think that the way to happiness is money, fame, power, and good looks.
Yeah, social media is this laboratory for the earthly goals that actually make you miserable.
Everybody is looking at other people's social media, what they believe to be other people's lives, which is only a snapshot of other people's lives, and feeling envy about that. And one of the things that Arthur and I talk about in this book is that envy is the great destroyer.
The happiness killer.
It is the happiness killer.
Oprah says she's had a front row seat to people's quest for happiness after 25 years on TV, interviewing more than 37,000 people.
Every day, I would sit and talk with the audience, and most people would always just say, well, I just want to be happy. I just want to be happy. Well, what does that look like?
Define it.
What I realize is that most people have never defined it. And then they'd say, well, I want my kids to be happy. Well, that's your kids, but what do you want? And so being able to answer specifically what that looks like for you is the beginning of being happier.
All happiness is a combination of enjoyment, satisfaction, and meaning. That's what we need. We need to enjoy our lives, which is not the same thing as pleasure. You know, the pursuit of pleasure will lead you to addiction and misery. Enjoyment adds in people and memories, which is the reason that beer ads never have a guy alone pounding a 12-pack in his apartment, but rather they have him with friends because they want it to be the source of enjoyment. Satisfaction is the joy that we get after a struggle, because humans are made to struggle and to achieve. And meaning is the hardest one. Meaning is the sense of coherence. You know, things happen for a reason. Direction and purpose. There is a reason for the things that are happening in my life, and there's a reason for my life.
What makes you happy in daily life?
So many things. Nature makes me joyous and so much happier.
Along with nature walks, Oprah also loves bread.
Oh my God, what?
Bread! Which is why we met her at the Amy's Bread Cafe in the Museum of the City of New York.
Olive fresh baked is always my favorite. Any of that here?
No, right here.
Wow.
As for Arthur's happy place, it's the gym in his basement, where you'll find him every day at 5 a.m.
You measure out
your
coffee rounds out the morning ritual.
How much is habit important in happiness?
It's important to actually have a routine for what you're trying to do to set your day up in the right way. Structuring your day is critically important.
Another thing that's important, accepting unhappiness as part of life.
The truth is all of us have suffering in our lives. The job is not to eradicate the suffering, it is to grow and learn from the suffering, because it is part of our life's journey. That is part of what it means to be fully alive. You can't be happy unless you're also unhappy.
You cannot control all of the external circumstances in your life, but you can control how you feel about those circumstances in your life. It boils down to the thing that I do when I go to teach in South Africa to my girls. I always teach a class called Life 101. And at the end of that class, I leave them with the poem Invictus. The last lines are, I am the master of my fate. I am the captain of my soul. And so taking control of your emotions and not allowing your emotions to control you, taking the wheel, allows you to be the master of your fate and the captain of your soul.
I love Invictus, and if I had on short sleeve shirts, you would see my goosebumps.
Oprah and Arthur have charted a course for happiness, and what seems to make them the happiest is teaching others all about it.
Any standout memories from writing the book together?
Well, everything with Oprah Winfrey is a standout memory. I mean, it's
Arthur says, you make him happy. Does he make you happy?
He makes me happy. I just look at his bald head and I just get happy. I look at that peanut head and it just makes me smile.
I'm the master reptile.